Hello everyone, welcome to Shake Hand with Life YouTube channel. I am Narendra Sharma. In this video, we will study the concept of hypothesis testing. Means, what is hypothesis? What is hypothesis testing? What is null hypothesis? What is alternate hypothesis? And how hypothesis testing helps in decision making. There are lots of definitions available in the books of statistics and on the internet regarding hypothesis and hypothesis testing in a very typical language. But here in this video, I'll make you understand the concept of hypothesis testing in a very decent and simple language. So stay with me till the end of this video and understand the concept of hypothesis testing. First, we understand what is hypothesis. So hypothesis is a predictive statement or a claim that we want to investigate or test using some data or statistical evidences or through physical observation. We collect some sample and test the claim and decide whether to accept the claim or reject the claim. For example, in a state election, the ruling party claiming that they have done pretty well for state development in the last 5 years, such as improved the basic amenities for public, improved the condition for state-owned schools, improved the condition for female security, etc., etc., etc. Now the voter has to test the claim and decide whether to accept this claim or reject this claim put by the ruling party on the basis of the conditions concerned to the claim in his or her area. Let's take another example. The maintenance department proposed that the regular maintenance will increase the efficiency of the machine. Here, maintenance department proposed that if the operator do the regular maintenance on the machine, then the machine will produce more quality parts in the same working hours. Here, the claim is tested on the basis of some data, like doing the maintenance for a week and observe the results and decide whether to accept this claim or reject this claim. So the hypothesis is simply a predictive statement or a claim which can be tested statistically to determine its validity. Now we talk about the null and alternate hypothesis. The null hypothesis is simply the historically accepted fact, and it is denoted by H0 or H0. Zero means empty or nothing. The alternate hypothesis is the claim or the proposition to be tested, and it is denoted by HA, where A represents the alternate hypothesis. It is also called the research hypothesis. It means there is a need to research and find the scientific evidences that support the alternate hypothesis. For example, Newton stated the law of gravity as the gravity is directly proportional to the mass of the objects and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. I hope all of you have studied this law in your science books in your primary classes. This law had been continued for 300 years and accepted as a fact of gravity until it was challenged by Albert Einstein as alternate hypothesis, which was general theory of relativity. It is a space-time relationship and its curvature, and when tested, it found more accurate law of gravity. Again, taking the example of elections, the ruling party claiming that they have done pretty well for the state development. So this one is the null hypothesis. But the opposition party claiming, no, they haven't done anything for state development. If we will come in power, then we will do much more for the state development. This one is the alternative hypothesis or research hypothesis proposed by the opposition party, which needs to be researched or tested using their past performances, their election manifesto and profile of the candidates, etc., etc. And on the basis of all, the voter will decide whether to accept the null hypothesis or alternate hypothesis, or in other words, whether he or she should vote for a ruling party or the opposition party. Another example, the owner of the company believes that the company is performing well enough to achieve its business objectives. This one is the null hypothesis, as it is assumed by the owner that the company's performance is very good with respect to achieving business objectives of the company. But the quality department proposed that if we train the employees on Six Sigma, then the company could achieve its business objectives much faster. So this one is the alternate hypothesis which needs to be tested or researched. Let's understand the concept of null and alternate hypothesis in more accurate terms. Suppose a company is performing with a monthly complaint size of 2% of the total products delivered. Here the quality department proposed that the employees' training will reduce the complaint size less than 2%. Here null hypothesis is H0 mu equal to 0.02. Here mu is the average value of monthly complaint size. And the alternate hypothesis is HA mu less than 0.02. Here the less than sign depicts the hypothetical result of reduced complaint size after employee's training. Here to decide that the employee's training would be effective to reduce complaint size, we have two possibilities. The first one is reject the null hypothesis, means employees' training will be effective to reduce complaint size less than 2%. The second one is fail to reject null hypothesis, means employees' training will not be effective to reduce the complaint size less than 2%. This implies we need to test the alternate hypothesis or the hypothetical result. That means to test the impact of the training on the employees. So here the company organizes the training for the employees for a few months and collect the complaint data. And if the complaint data comes as 1.75%, 1.50%, 1.20% or anything less than 2%, that means the complaint data actually reduced to less than 2% after employees' training. So in that case, the null hypothesis will be rejected, and if the complaint data not reduced to less than 2%, that means fails to reject the null hypothesis. It implies there is no impact of the training on the employees and there is no requirement to continue the employees' training. So this was the concept of hypothesis testing. I hope that you have clearly understood the concept of hypothesis testing. Like, what is hypothesis? What is hypothesis testing? What is null hypothesis? What is alternate hypothesis? And how hypothesis testing helps in decision making. So if you have any doubt, then please do write your feedback in comment box below. And if you like this video, then hit the like button and share this video among your friends and colleagues. Visit shakehandwithlife.in to download the course notes and ebooks in PDF. Subscribe Shake Hand with Life YouTube channel and press the bell to receive notifications of my future video lectures. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in my next video with a new topic. Till then, bye-bye.